Hi everyone. So it's going off about 2 in the morning on Friday night, Saturday morning, and I've just filmed another video about cats. If I've put it on the channel before this video, then you will know what I'm going on about. But if you don't, there is a random video about cats and my dog. Last night I filmed a video that is going up in a couple of hours, even though I've not scheduled it, so I'll have to do that when I get home. And it's about going in hospital, but without much details, but it is 10 minutes long, so there is obviously some details because it's 10 minutes long. I did start to film a second video, but I got so exhausted and I was falling asleep that I stopped filming it. So basically, I'm gonna film the second video, but I can't remember what I said or what I was gonna say, so whatever I say is probably news to me. So, as you'll be aware by now, I ended up in hospital and I got discharged the next evening, early evening, like 6, 7 o'clock, and I woke up in the middle of the night the next, like going into the next day and the bank holiday Monday, really feeling unwell and in some pain, and my throat felt on fire and I have acid reflux, but I'm on medication for it, so I shouldn't really get the burning sensation, but I had it and I kept waking up and it was pretty horrendous. And I've been ill for months and months and months, but I get treatment for it and then it never fully goes away, but there's only so much treatment they're willing to give and then it comes back. And I knew something was going on because I've been more exhausted than normal. I normally have 2 to 4 hours sleep a night and I'm tired all the time, but the tiredness had gone to another level. So I expected I was going to come down with a viral thing or a cold or something like that, and I didn't, but I was just more and more tired, and it didn't click in my head, but it should have clicked in my head what it was, because I've got something long term that just affects me. But because of everything that's going on in my life and stuff, I just didn't really think. I just thought I was exhausted because of everything else. But as I said, like, I was feeling ill, and it got to about 7 o'clock in the morning, and I got up for the day because by the time it was 7 o'clock in the morning, I was in a lot of pain, and I thought I'm going to end up in hospital. But there's certain things I need to do. I need to get some food in for my dad for a couple of days just in case, and I've got some work to do, and I need to do some tidying, and I need to sort stuff out that if I stay in, I'd want to take with me, and other things that I needed to do. So I got up, and it was a long day, and it took me ages to do the things I needed to do. Like, I possibly could have got them done in 3 hours maximum, but it took me a lot of the day because I kept having to sit down and things like that. And I told my dad that I knew I was going to end up in hospital again, and I was trying to not go in that day. I was trying to last as long as possible, but I can't even remember what time it got to. It was the evening and I was just in so much pain. I was exhausted and I'd started to be sick, and I passed out 2 or 3 times. I can't remember, because the night I went in on the Saturday, I'd fainted 3 times, so I can't remember if it was 2 or 3 times on the Monday. And obviously, because I'm being sick and I'm fainting, that's just what's worried me the most, because what as if I was sick and fainted straight away and I still had sick in my throat? I'd obviously choke to death, and I didn't want my dad to find me obviously choke to death. So I rang 111, and surprisingly, I got through in a couple of minutes, because when the person answered, I didn't expect it, because when I rang on the Saturday night, it took, I think it was 54 minutes for them to answer. So when he answered, I just thought it was the automatic answering thing that kept coming up every now and then. And basically, he sent an emergency ambulance, and as I said in the video, like the first response person turned up in about a minute, which really surprised me. Like, I didn't think I needed emergency assistance, but obviously they do a survey on the phone and ask certain questions, and basically the computer tells them what I need. So I obviously ended up in the back of an ambulance on the bed and got told I had sepsis. And I was like, oh, I feel fine, I don't feel that ill. I mean, I'm one of those people who doesn't like to talk about feeling ill. Like, I could be half dead and I'd be there going, yeah, I feel a little unwell. Like, I don't see the point in saying you're really ill. So for me to say, yes, I feel really ill, I have to be very, very ill. And the paramedic that was with me, he said, if you was in your 80s, you would feel a lot worse than you do, but because of your age, you're not feeling it the way you would do if you was a lot older. And then obviously I was hooked up to machines. They had like that where they put those pads on you and they connect you to the machine and they check your heart and whatever it is, and they were listening to my chest and doing other things. And then it told me that they were going to blue light me to the hospital, and I was there going, oh, there's no need for that, I don't feel that ill. And he's like, well, you've met all the criteria to go on a blue light with the sirens on. And I'm like, oh, please don't do that. He's like, no, we have to because you've hit all the criteria and we have to do it. And I was so embarrassed because obviously they put the lights on my street, and I was like, oh my god, my neighbours are just gonna be wondering what the hell's going on. And I was so embarrassed, and even though no one could see me, like, my neighbours knew it was me, and I was just really embarrassed. And I just thought it was a little bit dramatic because I just did not think I needed it, but they did. If you want to know what sepsis is, just look it up. But it's when your body can't cope with the infection, it starts shutting down, like your organs don't work properly and they don't do what they're meant to do. Which obviously is a worry because sepsis can cause death. So I was taken into Resus, and for the record, it's nothing like Casualty on telly. It's actually a lot bigger. And people are like curtained off, like in Casualty, everyone can see everyone, but in this you can't. And I was hooked up and up to all these machines, and I was struggling to breathe. Like, I couldn't catch my breath at that point. And a lot of it was because I was like a little bit stressed out, because to me it was just all dramatic and I didn't think I needed it, but they were all saying I need it. So obviously, I had no choice in everything that went on. I was hooked up to everything, and blood was taken straight away, and people were like watching me, and it was just like, oh God. And like, there was really sick people in there, and I'm there going, oh, I don't feel that ill. And they're like, well, you are really ill. Like, everything's showing that you're really unwell. And it was horrible being in Resus because, like, I don't cope well with any kind of illness. Like, when other people are ill, I can't cope with it. And there was a couple of really sad things that went on that night, and I don't want to talk about it because I'm not strong enough to talk about that because of how I'm feeling right now. But there's some pretty crap things going on in there. And a doctor came and saw me, and he looked me over, and he then like looked at the blood results, which they rushed through, and well, they got some through, and then he was looking at my history, and I was told him about how I'd been in and what was discussed, and those are the blood results that he'd looked at. And then he asked if we could take blood, and I am a nightmare to get blood out of.